Yes.
And my burden is light.
Yes.
And I literally, when I was writing it down, it broke apart. I looked at the words and I looked twice. And I just had this thought. My yoke is easy. Of course it's easy. Because Christ did everything that needs to be done for us to succeed.
Amen.
Yes.
Absolutely everything is done. And that's why the yoke is easy. And he said, my burden is light. And then the scripture came that he's the light of the world. All of my life I thought, you know, as a kid, we would work on the farm, in the farms. And I actually saw yokes of oxen and yokes, you know, that they would hook up these teams, either of horses or mules and whatever. Actually, I know how to do it. I mean, you know, I don't know if that's a skill real useful now, but I do know how to yoke them up. But I also knew that my grandfather would never yoke up. There always had to be one who was in control. It was never equal in that yoking up. Because if you put two people, two burden, two beasts in a yoke, and they were both in charge, nothing would get done.
Amen.
Nothing would get done. Absolutely nothing would get done. Nothing would be productive. You'd go and it would be the farmer battling the two who were always trying to each one go their way. But when he yoked up the one who was in charge and the other one then would follow, fields would get plowed. And trailers with hay would get moved. And things were done. But there always had to be one who was the lead in that yoke. Now a yoke, if it's one, it's a harness. And they do put those on cows when they go through fences and animals who won't stay where they're supposed to do. They put a single, similar to a yoke, to keep them from going out and getting lost. Well, when you're yoked, it is a pair. But you cannot go with someone who is, Christ is in that yoke with you. But the reason that it is easy is because he is walking right beside you, but he's leading. That's why it's easy. And it will change my mind for the rest of my life. It will change my thinking that when I am yoked beside him, nothing is impossible. Nothing is hard, nothing is insurmountable, and everything, you know, like the saying, don't sweat the small stuff. There is nothing that is too large or too big. There are no categories with God, because he created all things, and he said all things, and he told us to subdue it. How? Through him.
Amen.
So his yoke is easy, meaning you have to willingly go beside and walk beside while he leads, and then it's easy. Doesn't mean that there aren't going to be storms. There aren't going to be, you know, I don't know that I've ever told this, but when my children were small, I prayed, God, you've proved yourself to me. Now, I want you parted Red Seas. So my children, when they grow up, not just hear the word, but show them that you are supernatural, that you are the creator and the power beyond anything I can think. We used to live over in West Bradenton, and we would have to walk 32 blocks. And there was storming like this, and my kids, two children, were little. We didn't have a car. And so we were walking, and a horrendous storm came up and lightning. And my daughter was, I think she was five. And so my other son was not quite two. And she said, Mommy, what are we going to do? I said, we're going to pray. He parted the Red Sea, and you know, Egyptians were, he'll do the same for us. And as we spoke it, she said, part this storm. Lightning and everything, and there came a wind. You don't have to believe it, I was there. There came a wind and a tunnel, and we stepped inside the tunnel, and the rain was all around us and lightning, and we reached Manatee Memorial Hospital, and man who was walking, and he said, may I come inside? There was an angel in front of us. We could see him, and there an angel behind us. Amen. Because I asked that you prove yourself, show them that you're real. And so all the way till we got to our house, and as soon as we stepped in, the angels nodded, and the tunnel was gone. But if you've got a Red Sea to part, or Brother Richard, me, I've thought about it. I've thought about your son. If, because he healed lepers, and as a nurse, I've seen a leper's patient. They are missing. It said that when they came back, was whole. There's no mistake. They were whole. Now I'm going to be yoked with an easy thing because nothing is impossible. All things are done. And the other part of that scripture that came to me was I was looking down, and my burden is light. Now, in sign language, this is burden, meaning it's on your shoulder. And we always think about a burden as something we have to endure. And I've always thought a burden is something we endure, we get through, we learn to be kind and patient. But he said, my burden is light. What is he? He's the light of the world. You know what our burden is? As a Christian, I'm going to stop thinking it's tough. The only burden I have is to be a vessel that his light shows through.
Amen.
My burden, it says, and my burden, it's not even mine. It's not even my burden.
Right.
He said, and my burden, he didn't say your burden, did he?
Yep.
I mean, does the scripture, it says, and my burden,
amen,
is not even mine. I don't have a burden in the world. My burden is what? Light. What is he? He's the light of the world. Everything you face is his burden. Bottom line.
Praise the Lord.
Bottom line. Can't be any other way. Can't be. It says, my burden is what? Light. And I've always thought about it as, you know, lifting it, and so he'll always be there to help you lift it. That's not even it. He does do that, but it's light. He said that you are the light of the world. Are we not? His burden is for us to be a light in a dark world. To be a happy and a confident Christian. He says there'll be seasons you'll cry and you'll mourn, and then you'll rise up and go through your seasons, but it's his yoke. Step up and let him lead, go beside him. It's easy, because he said it is finished. By his stripes we are healed. Lazarus come forth, death is done.
Amen.
What is there that is not? But money in a fish's mouth. Everybody has things that God has done. But if we can keep in the framework that he is not the God that we describe, he is I am.
Amen.
It's my yoke. It's his yoke. It's easy. Just get in beside him and he'll lead and we'll go at the same thing. And his burden, not my burden, because if it say, and your burden will be light, it's not what he said. My burden is light. We are to be the light in this world.
Amen.
We are to be the one who walks into the doctor's office, in the grocery store, and in traffic, and we don't every time just react to everything that's going on around us. We are to be the light that he put within us.
Amen.
And my other thought that I had, I've had the privilege, and it's been not daunting, it's just been, I work on a project where there are athletes who have long-term careers, and some of them have Super Bowl rings and trophies and very humble people, and they love God. So I asked them the other day, what does it feel like when there are thousands and ten thousands of people shouting and calling your name and wanting to do? And they said, we didn't hear it. I said, how do you not hear that? He said, because when we play a game, we're not thinking about winning or losing, we're playing the game. We have practiced. We've shown up. We've done the exercises. We've studied the playbook.
Amen.
We know our opponent. And that there are penalties offsides. You can't grab somebody's helmet, face helmet. There are penalties. And I began to think it's just like the Word of God. There are things that, to me, grabbing the face helmet would be like gossiping about someone. There's a penalty. There's a penalty for it. If we offside, we try to knock someone, we try to cheat. There's those guidelines that say you can't do this, and every time you do this, it'll result the same. But they said in the winners and the losers locker room, each one, like at the Super Bowl, each one of those teams have competed on the same level that they're equal when they get there. But the difference is that the one who wins wasn't thinking about winning. The one who wins usually is the one who just goes out there and just keeps playing the game.
Amen.
They just keep playing the game. The only focus they have is, this is my game, and this is what I do. I'm sure David was like that when he was a young child. How could he have taken on beast of the field? How could he have seen a giant and not wavered? Because the only thing that he saw was what his God was.
Amen.
So I hope that helps. But to me, it's about, he says that we win the race. So obviously, it's a continuation. Every marathon runner has trained in some way or another when they get to the marathon. Not everyone finishes. Some people think about start training and then quit. But some consistently run the race. Because they're running the race. People who play in games and they become champions, it's because they continue to go their course that they run. But I'm glad he keeps revealing things. But his yoke is easy because there's nothing that I have to do except say his name. Now I know there are other things in the Bible, but the Bible says that if you call the name of Jesus, that's everything.
Amen.
That's the solution from beginning to end. And that his burden, it's not my burden. He carried that burden. From the cross to raising, he carried the burden. He took the stripes. And the Creator created everything, so everything is done. But his burden is that we would and it says, and the other thing, and then I'm done, his burden, so he's carrying the burden of you, he said, because he's always standing at the right hand of the Father, ever making what?
Intercession for us. Praise the name of our Lord.
Does that change your thinking of you as a victorious Christian? As a follower of Christ, he's ever carrying your burden.
Amen.
So when the enemy comes and says, oh, look at what you've got to deal with, I'm not dealing with it.
Amen.
I'm being light, and I'm going to tell people how it is to feel loved and what he did, and that he's the only one who could forgive what I did, and he's the only one who could change me, and he changed me by love and mercy and grace, and they'll have something that they'll want. That's the light.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.